Hello everyone and welcome to Perth South Model Railway. Today we're going to test the complete low-level system of tracks using train controller and a test timetable of 11 trains. The full layout once complete will form a folded figure of 8, so to test the low level on its own I formed a temporary connection at the location of my lifting bridge section so that trains avoid the main scenic level and stay in the low level. This is the test timetable, and it consists of 9 trains, with the first 2 using the reverse loops to return in the opposite direction, forming 2 additional trains. They will use the loops again at the end of the sequence so that they face their original direction once again. You will see that I use 4-digit train reporting numbers, similar to the prototype railway. These represent what train controller calls schedules or planned movements over the railway. I have set up these schedules so that they will only work for the designated train plus any locomotive. The train head code is also shown in the blocks in the train controller switchboard, much like a real signal box diagram. This works by having dummy trains named using the 4-digit head code. To these dummy trains, e.g. train 1 alpha 01, can be added the real locomotive. In this case, D368. Any number of real or dummy trains can be added together to form what train controller calls a train set. Any rules in the schedule applying to 1 alpha 01 will also apply to the locomotive attached, such as routing of the train or instructions to blow whistle or horn or other effects. And so to the trains. We have 3 Class 1 Express passenger trains, the first hauled by a Class 40 diesel, the second a Coronation Pacific, and the third a Class 26 diesel. 2 Class 2 local passenger trains, one hauled by an A4 Pacific and the other a Black 5. 2 Class 4 fast freights, including a fish train hauled by an A2 Pacific and a general fitted freight hauled by a Thompson B1. And finally, 2 Class 9 unfitted slow freight trains, one an empty coal train hauled by a WD Austerity, and a general unfitted freight hauled by another Class 26 diesel. The schedule starts at 0600 and nominally lasts for 6 minutes, but in practice it's impossible to run them all on that timescale, and so train controller will run the trains as quickly and efficiently as it can, depending on the number of conflicting moves encountered. Because of the track layout and the fact that any train can use any of the sidings, the detailed sequence will change every time the timetable is run. So the time is now 05:59. Let's see what happens.
Thank you.
Well, all is quiet again at the end of that sequence of movements, and no collisions or derailments. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you again soon.